See, as far as the donors are concerned, the only restriction that they have is that for the first 3 or 4 months, they do not have to lift heavy weight. All of them, they have a very normal recovery. They are out of the hospital in a week's time. And then long term, they don't have to take any medicines. They don't have to visit the hospital on a regular basis for the reasons that they have donated. Right? So they are just like any other person. Only restrictions for heavy physical work being for the first 3 to 4 months. When it comes to the recipients, then obviously it's a different scenario altogether. And the recipients have to be very careful. The first thing that we tell them is that even after a transplant, it's not like you will be out of the hospital and you will not be in contact with the hospital or your doctors. So these patients, they have to take medicines for their entire life. They have to do tests, blood tests essentially, and these are simple tests just to monitor the liver function test, which they will have to do on regular intervals. Initially for the first year they are more frequent. After that, as the time passes by and the liver gets adjusted into their bodies, the frequency of the tests also decrease. But then they will have to be under some monitoring for their entire life. The other important thing for the recipients is that they have to be very, very careful not to go in an environment where they can catch infections. They have to be very careful about not eating outside, or if at all they are in a situation where they can't help but they have to eat outside, they have to choose the right places, clean places, and the right food. So not things which are cold, but things which are freshly cooked and given to them. They have to be very careful, carry their own bottle of water wherever they go, right? So food, water, these are the most common sources of infection. Right now, whenever they go into a busy place, whenever they are in a crowded place, whenever they are using public transport, they have to wear a mask. They have to bring hand hygiene practices into their normal living. So using hand sanitizers, frequent soap, hand washes with soap and water, all these things the recipients will have to inculcate as a lifestyle, and this they will have to continue for their entire life. So there are some restrictions to them, but more than restrictions, it's about living a disciplined life, taking the medicines on time, getting the tests in time, and then whenever they do the tests or whenever they have problems, without any delay, they should be contacting their doctors, the transplant team. And we follow up with our patients. We follow them for their entire life. Even patients who have had a transplant with us 10 years ago, we are still in touch with them. And our coordinators do a fantastic job in helping out the patients with all their queries and follow up. The liver transplant is essentially a teamwork. So the liver transplant surgeons are the face of the team majority of the times. But then, just like a human body, where if you just have a face, you don't have your hands, legs, yeah, then you are dead, right? So similarly, in a transplant team also, unless and until the entire team functions together, this team is as good as non-functional. So we have transplant surgeons, we have hepatologists, we have anesthetists, we have critical care experts, we have our coordinators, social workers, all these, our infectious diseases specialists, pulmonologists, cardiologists, all of us, and there are many more. Sometimes patients have kidney issues, so we have to get the nephrologists involved. The nurses become the most important pillars of patients' well-being in the post-operative period. The OT nurses become very, very important for us to operate there and operate safely. So it is at least 16, 17 different specialties which are working together harmoniously and ensure that the patients, they have a good outcome. So it's a teamwork. If you have to look at a specialty, and if you have to give an example of a specialty where teamwork is the most important thing, I think it has to be a transplant, liver transplant. So we work together as a team, all specialists together. Before the surgery, we discuss the entire case file of the patient in a meeting. We call it the listing meeting. And once the patients are gone through and get approval of all the different specialties, only then we proceed with the transplant. After the operation also, the rounds on the patients, they are carried by all the specialties, not just the liver transplant surgeon or the intensivist, but the infectious diseases, the endocrinologist, everyone. So, a lot of specialties we round together and we work together as a team. So, that's how it works out for transplant.